Welcome back to History with Mr. B. This day in history, March 28th, 1814, 209 years ago, there was a funeral for a very special man, Dr. Joseph Ignace Guillotin. Yes, the namesake of the man that invented the execution device in France, the guillotine. All right, now here's the crazy part of all this. He was actually a philanthropist, Dr. Guillotin, and he had the purest motives for inventing a device that would execute kings the same way as peasants, the same way as tradesmen. And he was super upset that the guillotine became a symbol of revolution and killing and all this, because he actually made it so, all right, this is the safest, most humane way, painless way to kill someone. However, if you are in the audience, it is a visceral experience. And I'm going off what I've read in primary sources. The blood will squirt out of a decapitated head up to 30 feet. The eyes will stare back and forth when they hold the head up for up to 30 seconds. And that whole thing is just traumatic. But the machine was intended to show intellectual and social progress of the French Revolution. And the first use of the guillotine was April 25th, 1792. A man was found guilty of armed robbery and murder, and he was decapitated by the guillotine. Now, the crowd seemed to miss the gallows at first, because all of this is done in public in France. This is a public execution, and everyone really liked the public hangings. But eventually the guillotine caught on and the crowds were gigantic for these things. In fact, the last execution in France with the guillotine was in 1977. And that person was the last person to die with the death penalty of beheading in the Western world. It's against all rules now. But that is the guillotine, Dr. Joseph Ignace Guillotin. Thanks for stopping in today and stopping tomorrow for March 29th, this day in history.